like a long time, but nothing seems like a long time when I am waiting. I feel like I'm walking on water since the day that I asked your God to let go of these dark.
Our purpose of gathering here this evening to wait in the presence of God, family and friends, to witness the sacred vows of marriage of Paige Brett Mason and Kendall Lachey Harvey. Who gives this young lady to be this man's wife? You may be seated.
As a servant of God and her, and throughout your life, Kendall, as a handmaid of the Lord and wife, the covenant of marriage is an institution designed by God Himself, and except for His covenant of grace, it is the most solemn, serious, intimate, and tender into which two human hearts can enter. It's so sacred, in fact, that death alone should ever sever this holy bond. Disobedience to these vows is, in God's sight, treacherous dealing. Profanes what He made holy and brings down His wrath upon the guilty. Thus, as you enter into this covenant of marriage, having thoughtfully and reverently considered the duties and obligations that grow out of this relationship, may I charge you both in the presence of God and all here to remember that love and loyalty toward Christ, and then for one another, stand as the only firm foundation, the only sure footing for a happy Christian home. Of course, marriage has its trials, and yet as you face these as Christians, you may be assured that your respect and devotion for one another will deepen and that abiding joy will grow with each passing year. As you look back over the hard times and realize that they've made you both stronger, more responsible, and mature. It's God Himself that said it's not good for man to be alone. Sometime later, Paul wrote, "Let marriage be had in honor among all." It's only a little reflection on the subject to see why these statements were made. Even the paradise of the Garden of Eden was incomplete for Adam alone. In His infinite wisdom, God solved the problem by bringing a deep sleep upon Adam. From the flesh and bone of Adam himself, Eve was made, presented as a bride, a helper for him. With their union, the first marriage was celebrated. We can only imagine that against the background of Eden, the moon and stars were the candelabra, the nightingales sang, the divine word and the Holy Spirit were witnesses, and the Almighty Himself officiated. The first marriage set a pattern for all the sons and daughters of Adam. Let it be remembered that Adam was created first, and for him, Eve was made. The husband is, therefore, head, provider, and protector in the family. He was not taken from his head so as to rule over him. Neither was she taken from his foot that he might trample upon her. She was taken from his side to stand by him in all that life offers. She was taken from under his arm that he might protect and provide for her. She was taken from his heart so that he should love and cherish her as his own body. Between two humans, then, there are no other ties more tender, no other vows more sacred than the ones you will now take. So I ask, will you, Caleb, take Kendall as your lawfully wedded wife, promising to love her as you do your own self, to nourish and cherish her, leaving all others, and cleave to her in order to protect and remain with her in sickness and adversity, as well as health and prosperity, taking as your ultimate example Christ's love for His church, until death shall separate you from you. And you, Kendall, take Caleb as your lawfully wedded husband, promising that you will be to him a helper suitable for him, to love, honor, and cherish him, to remain with him in sickness and adversity as well as health and prosperity. But forsaking all others, you will be subject to him, taking the church's respect for Christ as your pattern, until death shall separate you both. I, Caleb, take you, Kendall, to be my wedded wife, to have and to hold, from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. Kendall, would you repeat these words after me? I, Kendall, take thee, Caleb, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. For your vows to be further sealed by the giving and receiving of rings. precious metal of these rings remind you of the precious God you take this day. And the unending circle of that one remind you of the unending and undying love you place in each other. You take that and place it in the center of that corner. With this ring, I be ready. With all my worldly goods, I be endowed. My name, my wealth, my life, until death do us part. You still got it anyway. Repeat after me. With this ring, I be ready. And with all that I have, I be endowed. Myself, my life, my all, until death do us part. Symbolic of the surrender of self and uniting their life together, Caleb and Kendall will now light the unity candle. Our Father and our Lord God, we're grateful for the blessing we have this night of sharing together this special moment. The Caleb and Kendall have invited us to be with us this morning. As they pledge and vow their love for one another and their desire to live together in honor as husband and wife, we pray that you would bless them with a long and fruitful life of service to thee and to one another. As they begin their life together, we pray that you would give them the love, patience, forgiveness, and endurance to make their home everything that you want it to be and everything that they desire to be. We ask for wisdom for Caleb that he might always be able to guide his family, provide for them, and to help them as he leaves the home. And that we would give a spirit of submissiveness and a spirit of Christian love as she yields as a helper suitable for this man she has pledged her life to. We ask, Father, therefore, you would bless and sanctify the relationship and make it holy in thy sight. For we ask in the name of Jesus Christ, your Son, and our Savior. Amen.
Thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, would you join me as we welcome? That's the wrong song. I'm so sorry. Here's a bit. No, that's still the wrong song. Let's go with this one. For the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Caleb Mason.
Whoever's hands on top means they're in charge. That's what I was told. And when it's in my hand, well, I know when it's in my hand, well, I don't have to be on top. Yes, the knife. The bottom. The bottom.
Kendall, just remember that opportunity only knocks on some doors just a couple times, maybe. So you might want to take some chances when you get down. Are you guys ready?
Yep.
On the count of three, Caleb, be nice. Kendall,
look at
go for it. One, two, three.
Hey, y'all couple up.
Huh?